survey says it's 6 o'clock, time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Danielle.
Thanks for joining us here on Family Feud. Look, we're going to have a lot of fun tonight with our two families as they try to guess the top answers to some simple questions. Let's meet them now. First up, our carryover champs here for their third night from Tweed Heads in New South Wales, the Lockhart family. Hi, Lena.
Hello again.
Remind Australia who's on board.
So I've got my brother, Eric, my beautiful mum, Lynn, and my future sister-in-law, Madison.
Good to have you back. And ready to take them on tonight from Adelaide, South Australia, the Neubauer family. Brigitte, how are you?
Very well, nice to meet you.
Good to see you. Who'd you bring?
My three fabulous sisters, Veronica, Monica and Anne.
Lovely. Welcome, everybody. Righto, team captains, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top seven answers are on the board. Name a type of egg. Brigitte.
Chicken.
Chicken. Good. Lena.
Fried.
Fried egg. It's there. Neubauer has it. Pass or play? You gonna play? Cool. Hey, Veronica, how
Hi,
you doing?
I'm good.
Tell us about yourself.
Me?
Yeah.
Well, I've just recently quit an admin job to go out and be a ninja window cleaner with my other half.
A ninja window cleaner?
Yeah.
Did you just come up with that name or is that an actual role?
That's the actual name of our company.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
That's cool. Is that because you just spring from the roof and go down the sides of buildings?
Yeah, or... yeah, and we have to sometimes crawl under staircases and clean little windows and...
Just do a forward roll into the office and go, we're here!
No, we normally ding the doorbell and go, ninjas are here.
Wow. And people go, ah! And slam the door. The ninjas are back! Yeah, holy moly.
It's a great job.
Are you subtitled as well? Like, do you sort of go, we are here? To clean your windows.
No, my other half does that.
You've got to have a laugh.
Yeah, for sure.
Type of egg?
Well, I hate chocolate, but I'm going to say Easter egg.
Yeah. Is that on the board?
Yes!
Yeah. Hang on a second, you hate chocolate?
I do. I had to force some chocolate brownie in before for a bit of energy. And
Who hates chocolate?
Oh, give me a gherkin any day.
that's the second weirdest thing I've heard today. First I hate chocolate, then give me a gherkin.
Well, we're German, so either that or sauerkraut.
Right. Nice. Good times, everybody.
Yeah.
Monica.
Hi.
Name a type of egg.
Poached.
Poached egg.
Yeah.
Not on the board, I'm afraid. Anne, can you name a type of egg?
Okay, I'm going to say duck.
Duck egg.
Yep.
Yeah. Nice. Not a bad start.
I'm going to say quail egg.
A quail egg. Second strike. Ooh. The Lockhart family could steal, so they're having a think of an option over there.
What about some scrambled eggs?
Scrambled.
Yeah.
Eggs. Yeah. That's three strikes. So Lockharts. What do you reckon, Madison?
Emu.
Emu egg. Lynn?
I've cooked many of them. I'd say boiled egg.
Good. Eric?
I'd go with boiled egg as well.
Lena? You're the boss. Yours to choose.
I'm going to go with Eric and Mum with boiled egg.
Boiled egg it is!
Yes!
Nice job, two Lockharts! Remaining answer on the board, number six. Free range. There. So well done, Lockharts. 58 points is your lead right now. They grab the opening blow, and if one of these families wins for five nights in a row, they'll drive home in a brand new Mitsubishi ASX. Now, the Street Smart ASX is packed with features including active traction and hill start control, seven airbags, plus reversing parking camera and sensors. For everybody playing along at home, I want the top answer to this question. What's the most effective one-word command? We'll be back with the answer in just a moment on the Feud. What's the most effective one-word command? The top answer was...
Stop!
Excellent work, everybody. Give me Eric, give me Veronica. Let's play the Feud! surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something that people normally use in the pool. Veronica.
Floaties.
Let's try that. Lovely work, Neubauers. After play. Consider yourself a crash magnet, Monica.
Nobody likes my new cars.
Are you one of those sad people that gets a brand new car and someone hits it straight away?
Unfortunately,
oh,
yes.
Oh, man. I see that so often. Man, well, how many times are we talking here?
Four!
Into the one car?
No, different cars.
So, like, a new car, bang.
Yep.
New car, bang.
Yep.
A lot of damage each time?
The second one was the worst. My Jeep, brand new Jeep, about month old, $20,000 damage.
She crashed a Jeep.
I did.
Wouldn't happen with an ASX. Safest house are 7 airbags. You're going to love that. Name something that people normally use in the pool.
A ball.
Use a ball in the pool. Nice work. You have lots of bike accidents, Anne. Like on your push bike?
Yes, push bike.
And just what happens? Obviously Monica comes along and just knocks you off.
Well, I've been riding with all of them and unfortunately Brigitte doesn't really know her left and right, so when we get to a particular point and she says, go left, and she goes right, and then it's Bushka.
You know, what I reckon you guys need to do?
It's true.
Get a taxi.
Might be safer.
It'll be safer for everybody.
Yeah.
Name something that people normally use in the pool.
As unattractive as they are, I'd say a swimming cap.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Not on the board, I'm afraid, Anne. Brigitte?
Goggles.
Goggles, you yes. would, so you can see in the water and you don't yes. hurt your eyes.
That's right.
Lovely. Monica.
What about yeah. flippers?
Flippers, yes. Good work. Back to you, Monica. Something that people normally use in the pool.
I'd like to be on one right now, an air mattress.
Just, well, there's nothing really stopping you. Wouldn't you rather be here just like trying to win some money or just on an air mattress?
On an air mattress.
On an air mattress. Good. The old Lilo.
All right, something else you need to blow up. I'm thinking the rubber ring.
Yeah.
You sit in.
Pretty safe. Yep. They're in a lot of pools. Is yep. it on the board? In a tube. Righto, back to you, Captain. Two left on the board. Not bad.
I'm going to go a snorkel this time.
Oh, a snorkel, so you can breathe underwater. Second strike. The Lockharts are going to think of an option over there in case they get the chance. Veronica.
Like a boogie board?
Yeah, not a bad option.
Yeah.
Shall we see if it works?
Boogie board.
Let's
go for that.
That's three strikes. Over to the Lockharts. Madison.
I'm going to say noodle.
Nice. Lynn.
Well, you need it to clean the pool, so I'm saying a pool cleaner.
Cool. Eric.
A creepy crawly.
How's it going?
Pool cleaner. Creepy. pool cleaner.
Ooh, well played. Lena.
I'm going to go with Maddie because there's so much fun in the pool. A pool noodle.
A pool noodle. Is it on the board for the win? That gets you the round. Well done. Takes 30 points to 148. Congratulations. Last answer on the board is...
Chlorine.
To go with your pool filter, think. Pool guy. Double points time. Give me Lynn, give me Monica. Let's do it. We surveyed 100 people and the top 6 answers are on the board. Name something people don't like to share. Lynn.
Information.
Information. Not on the board. Monica, name something people don't like to share.
Their hard-earned money.
Their money. Excellent work. Something people don't like to share, Anne?
Well, if I was a kid, well, when I was a kid, I'd say toys.
Excellent. Let's give that a shot.
Yes.
Oh! I was convinced. Could you tell? Not on the board, though. First strike.
Secrets.
Ooh. Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. Good one. Yes. Yeah.
Veronica, name something people don't like to share.
Their toothbrush.
Why?
Because it's gross.
It so is icky. I
know. Yeah. Yeah.
Three to go, Monica.
Well, if you like food like I do, food.
You don't like the sheep food. Hey, this is looking good, guys. One strike down, two left on the board.
Okay, partner. Just saying.
It's a fair point. I'm glad you're putting it out there.
Hope it's up there.
Righto. Just one away from getting you guys your first points tonight. What is it?
Germs.
I don't like girls' germs. It's not second strike, so the Lockharts could steal. What's number two, Veronica?
Probably your underwear.
I've never thought of that. Is it underwear? Three strikes. You gotta try. Lockhart family, Madison.
Hairbrush.
Lynn.
Their car.
Eric.
Ice cream.
Lena.
Well, with four sisters, I really hated sharing my clothes.
Oh, that's not bad. Should we give that a shot? We like the look of it, so the Lockharts. Is that number two? Oh. Not this time. Welcome to the game, Neubauer. You got some points for 116. Nice work. Number two. So it's 148 to the Lockhart family, 116 to the Neubauers. We've got ourselves a nice, interesting, fun game tonight. Look, if you're looking for more Family Feud, you can go online. You can watch the highlights from the show and also play the official Family Feud game. Just click on 10, play all the details are there. Triple points when we come back on the Feud. They're in the game now, man. They got some points on the board, 116. They're full of confidence right now. They're chasing down the leaders, the Lockhart family, 148. It's a close one. It's a family who gets the 300 points in this round. We'll get a chance of $10,000, and we're playing for triple points now. OK, best of luck. Madison, and let's play the Feud. We surveyed 100 people, and the top seven answers are on the board. Name a red food.
Yummy, yummy raspberries.
Yummy, yummy raspberries. Oh. Not on the board. Madison.
Tomatoes.
Tomatoes are red. Yes. Good job. Oh. Nice play. Name a red food.
Apple.
Apples are red. And on the board. Name a red food, Eric.
I'm going to go with strawberries.
That's not a bad option. Good job. Lynn?
Well, I use them in my salads and beetroot.
Beetroot. Yeah. Madison.
Watermelon?
Watermelon.
When it's cut.
Okay. Not on this occasion. First strike. Back to you, Lena.
I really love cherries, so I'm going to say cherry.
Cherries have got to be there. Yes, they are. Two to go, guys, and you got this sewn up. What is it, Eric?
I think it'll be with capsicum.
Does it work? Yeah, it does. Nice little posse to be in right now.
It is.
You guys are sitting pretty. Just one left on the board. One strike down.
I'm hoping this is in my salad too, and it's a radish.
Radish could be on the board. Is that number five to seal the deal? Oh. Second strike. The Neubauers could steal, so they're having a think over there, Madison. You've got to come up with something good now. Name a red food.
Peach.
Peach.
Could be.
Pinky side of red, says pinky Madison, red. But that could be red. Are they? Three strikes. Neubauer's. You get an all-important shot at this right now, Anne.
Red grapes.
Monica.
Craisins that you put in salads.
Interesting. Veronica.
Cranberries.
What's it going to be, boss? Yours to choose. You currently trail triple point round. You get this, you get number five, you got the game. You're the new champs.
I'm going for something different to my sisters. Ooh. I'm going to go for rhubarb.
Rhubarb is red, says the captain.
Yes.
The audience is a little lukewarm on that. But it's your call. That's your right. That's your prerogative. This could give you the game if rhubarb is number five. Is it? Sorry, you guys. Congratulations, Lockharts. Again, our champions. This is that pesky number five. Yes. Oh, man, the whole audience is going... Good on you guys, Veronica, Monica and Anne. You guys played really well and fought hard to the end. We're going to give you guys a gift card from eBay worth a whopping $1,000 to spend at Australia's largest online shopping destination, eBay. And you'll also be taking home the Family Feud board game as well. Please thank them. They tried hard. They played well. Lockhart, who's in for Fast Money? Lena and Lynn. We've so far reached 190 points out of 200 twice. We're going to break that. We're going to get $10,000 right now, tonight, so we can celebrate. Yes?
Yes.
Head back to our soundproof booth, which is just back that way, and we play for 10 grand next on Fast Money. Don't go anywhere.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10 Play.
Time here on the Feud, so let's see if the Lockhart family can now win some cash. If you and Lena get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000. Third time lucky. I reckon we
can
do this. Lena's now in our soundproof booth and can't hear your answers. I'm going to ask you five questions and I'll give you 20 seconds to answer. If you pass, we'll come back if there's time and the clock starts at the end of the first question. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck. If a millionaire loses their money, name something else they might lose.
Their mind.
Name something you might do on a romantic picnic.
Kiss.
What's the most frustrating thing about computers?
Pass.
Apart from a lamp, what would you find on a bedside table?
Telephone.
Name a colour you associate with a bridesmaid's dress.
White.
Just out of time, I'm afraid, but really good try. Okay, we can still do it. Let's go. So you got that last answer in, but not enough time, sadly, to go back to question number three, but here we go. If a millionaire loses their money, name something else they might lose. You said their mind. Funny answer. Survey says... Ooh, six. Six people agree. What's something you might do on a romantic picnic? You said you might kiss. You should if it's romantic.
It's romantic.
Yes. Survey says... There we go. Unfortunately, here's the dreaded question three. What's the most frustrating thing about computers? You unfortunately didn't answer, therefore zero is the score. Apart from a lamp, what would you find on a bedside table? You said. Got your telephone there. Survey says. 10. Name a colour you associate with the bridesmaid's dress. You said. It's got to be white. Survey says. 1868. Tough round, Lynn, but not impossible. Head back to the family, clear the board. Welcome back, Lena. A little bit of work to do. You've got to get a score of 132 to get $10,000, okay? I'm going to ask you the same five questions, but as you're the second player, it can be a little harder. As you know, you'll get an extra 5 seconds. If you pass on a question, I'll ask it again if there's time, and if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound. And I'll ask you to try again. So can we remind everybody of Lynn's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. The time starts from the end of that first question, so good luck. If a millionaire loses their money, name something else they might lose.
House.
What's something you might do on a romantic picnic?
Drink champagne.
What's the most frustrating thing about computers?
They won't turn on.
Apart from a lamp, what would you find on a bedside table?
Glass of water.
Name a colour you associate with a bridesmaid's dress.
Blue.
Not a bad job.
This feels pretty good. Let's go. Here we go.
If a millionaire loses their money, name something else they might lose. You said house. To lift ourselves from what is a bit of a tough score on the left-hand side, we'll get off to a good start with the top answer. That's nice. It's pulling us now within reach. What's something you might do on a romantic picnic? You said drink champagne. Survey says 18. Now, Lynn had the top answer of this. So we need 84 points to get you guys $10,000. What's the most frustrating thing about computers? You said when they won't turn on. Survey says no, 9. Low scores are also annoying from computers. Come on, board, give us more than that. Slow speed was the top answer, 75 points now required. Apart from a lamp, what would you find on a bedside table? You said glass of water. Survey says 7. Oh. Alarm clock was the top answer. So we need 68 from this last one now. Name a colour you associate with a bridesmaid's dress. You said blue. We hoping?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Fingers crossed. Survey says